Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So here I'll be going to draw helix of a cone. So first I'll explain with the shape of a cone made with paper. So this is how the cone is if you want to make with the paper. Now for the cone in the question, we have been given the diameter, that is the base. We have been given the height, so we have been given the base diameter, we have been given the height, and we have been given the height of the pitch. So this is the pitch height till where the curve or the helix ends. So if I start to draw a helix on this, so this is how it will be. It will start from here. There will be a line, a curve. A helix is nothing but a winding of a thread on a cone or a three-dimensional object. So this is the winding of a thread for one complete convolution. So it starts from here, ends at here, at the height, and this height where it ends, that is the height of a pitch. Now I'll draw it manually. First I'll draw a straight horizontal line. First we will draw the top view. The top view of the cone will be a circle with diameter given as 75. So from here I'll draw a circle with radius of 37.5 millimeters. I'll draw a line passing through the center from the ends. Now as the circle doesn't have any sides, we'll divide the circle into 12 equal parts. You can divide the circle into 6-8 equal parts. The more the division, the more points you get to plot. You can do this sum with 8 equal parts also. That will be a bit easy, but you will get less points to plot. In this 12 division, you will get more points and it will look much perfect. So I'll mark the center as O, the divisions as 1 to 12. Now height of the cone given is 100 millimeter. So from the horizontal line, I'll mark a point 100 millimeter above. And as the front view of the cone is a triangle, so I'll join this and this end. So this is the front view of the cone. I'll just mark the dimension. The height of this cone is 100 millimeters. And the diameter of the cone is 75 millimeters. Now moving forward, I'll draw parallel line through these points. I've taken these points upward towards the front view. Now joining this, as it's a cone, you have to join this to the center. Extend this line, join it to the center. I'll mark these points. This is O dash, 1 dash, this is 2 dash, 12 dash. According to this, mark these points. Naming the points properly will help you a lot. So do it. Now next, I'll mark the height of the pitch, which is 75 millimeter. So from this end, I'll mark a point 75 millimeter above. So this is where the helix ends. So I'll draw a line through it. Now next, as you can see, the helix starts and ends here. And this height is the pitch height. Now this is how the curve will be. The helix, it will start from here and end till here. So to do that, as we have divided the circle into 12 equal parts, we will divide the slant line into 12 equal parts. So to divide the slant line into 12 equal parts, the best way is that draw 45 degree angle line. Divide that 45 degree angle line into 12 parts using the compass. Take any distance and cut it 12 parts. Then join the last point and taking that as the reference line, draw parallel lines through each of those points. So with this method, you can divide the slant line into 12 equal parts. After division, draw the horizontal lines from those intersections on the slant line. So this is how we have divided the cone into 12 parts. Now to mark the points to draw the curve, this is the first point. It starts from here, it ends at here. So this is the first point. Now 2 dash and 2 intersection. This will be 3, 4. This is how the point will move. So to start, this is the first point, this is the second point. I'll mark this first point as P1. This is the second point. Now naming properly, this is 1, this mark 2, 3, 4, 5 till 12. And again, last point is 1. Now 1 intersection is P1. 2 dash and 2 intersection is P2, 3 and 3 dash intersection is P3, this is P4, then this is P5. I'm marking only the points, one leaving, so it doesn't looks complicated. P7, then 8 and 8 dash intersection is P8, this is P9. Then 10 and 10 dash intersection, this is P10, this is P11, this is P12, and finally again this is P1. This is where it ends. Now you have to join this. You can join this with freehand or you can use French curve. Use French curve as it looks proper. The curve looks smooth. So look how I have used the French curve. You can use it that way only. This part will be dotted as this is behind. This line goes behind the cone. As you can see here, this is the front line, so it is dark visible. So this line is at the front, it is dark visible. And this is the line which goes behind, so it looks dotted. So we have drawn it dotted, which is hidden. Now next, we will open this cone and we'll draw its development. So for that, first we will draw a curve. The radius will be the slant line. I'll just mark this dimension. This is the pitch height. Now to draw this development, first we will find this angle. That angle, I'll mark it as theta. So this theta formula is base width upon the slant height. Now slant height, you can calculate it directly by measuring with the scale, but you can directly calculate the slant height using the formula, that is the Pythagoras theorem. As we know the width, this width, and you know the height, that is 100, and the width is nothing but the radius, that is 37.5. So base width is 37.5 upon the Pythagoras theorem, which says root of 37.5 square plus 100 square. So this formula will give me the slant height. So that totally gives me 126.4 degrees. So as we have found the angle, first we will extend this curve. Now I'll mark that angle, that is 126.4 degrees. I'll join this till it attaches the curve. Now as we have divided the cone into 12 equal parts, we will divide this angle also into 12 equal parts. So now 126.4 degrees divided by 12 will be around 10.5 degrees. So I'll mark the points at an angle of 10.5 degrees. You can use angle bisector, or this is the easy method. You can do this. Take each angle as 10.5 degrees and mark the points and draw the lines. So this is how we have divided the angle into 12 equal parts. Now taking this projections on this angle curve also, as you can see, this division 12, I've drawn curves from each and every point. Now this is the first point. Then according to this, this is the second point. I'll mark this as P2. This is P1, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, 9, 10 until again P1. Now this is the first point. P2 and 2 intersection, this I'll mark it as B. P3 and 3, this is C. P4 and 4 intersection, this is D. Likewise, do the markings. E, this is F, G. P8 and 8 intersection will be H. I, J, K, L, and again A. So this is the curve we have got. This is the development of the cone. We'll join these points using French curve, which we will get a smooth curve. This line will be dark. So this is the curve of the helix when the cone is open. Now this helix shape, we will draw it in the top view also. So for that, we'll take these projections towards the top view from the front view, where this helix intersects the front view. Those points we are projecting downwards towards the top view. So we are taking all these lines, points downwards towards the top view. This is the first point. Now this will be the first or the starting point. This will be the second point, that is 2. Then P3 and 3 intersection will be third point. P4, this points will draw it later. P5 and 5 intersection will be next point. Then 6 and P6 intersection on this line will be this point. Then P7 intersection, P8 and 8 where it intersects, as you can see, this line intersects on this 8th line will be next point. P9 and 9 intersection, this point. Then P10 will draw it later. Then P11, that is this point. P12, and this is the final point, that is P1. Now I'll mark these points as P1 to P12. So this is the spiral. This is the Archimedean spiral. P4 and P10 points, I'll show you how to plot it. That will be on the slant line. So for marking these points, so this is the point, that is P4. We'll take this projection on the slant line that is already there, that is this point. And we have to take that projection downward towards the top view. So this point projection, take it towards the top view, which intersects on the axis line. Now take the compass, take this distance and mark it on the vertical line, that is this. So this is the point, that is P4. And same like that for P10, this is the point where it intersects. From this point, we take the projection downwards towards the top view. Now take the compass, take this distance and cut an arc on this line. So this point will be P10. So this is how you achieve these points. As those are aligning on the axis line, we are not able to plot. So we do it like this way. Now joining all these points using French curve, and which achieves us the Archimedean spiral. So with this, we are totally done with the sum. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. If you have any doubts, any queries, let me know in the comment section.